Lawmakers have begun voting on the 11th hour deal, the bipartisan deal, to avert the historical debt default. You're looking at a live picture of the Senate floor right now. Officials in Washington say they have more than 60 votes in the Senate in favor of the new deal that was reached. And here's a look at what that deal entails.
It's never easy for two sides to reach consensus.
But it appears a consensus has been reached.
Political adversaries set aside their differences and disagreements to prevent that disaster.
The details, according to sources, fund the government until January 15th, raise the debt limit until February 7th, set up budget negotiations between the House and Senate in the hopes of reaching a long-term deal, and strengthen verification measures for those seeking federal subsidies under Obamacare. The ball went back into the Senate's court late Tuesday night when a House Republican plan fell apart.
After yesterday's events, the Majority Leader and I began a series of conversations about a way to get the government reopened and to prevent default.
It's up to Speaker John Boehner to put the Senate plan up for a vote in the House, and he said he'll do just that.
We've been locked in a fight over here trying to bring government down to size, trying to do our best to stop Obamacare, and we fought the good fight. We just didn't win.
And the vote on the deal began just after 4:30 our time. Right now, all eyes on the Senate floor where that voting is expected to wrap up shortly. Again, the new deal is expected to pass. Now it's on to the House, where it's also expected to pass there. So Todd and Jackie, it seems the government shutdown could be coming to an end soon.